I do happen to know how to build a house that's nice to live in and also protects me from wind and rain, said Hoggy. Nah, you don't have a clue about that. I can build a much better house than can cope with just about anything, said Oinky. Come on, guys. Boasting doesn't mean you get to build a great house. You have to think sensibly and knowledgeably and build it to withstand all dangers, whatever they may be, said Piggy. The three little pigs discussed who could build the best and safest house. Hoggy said that bales of straw piled on top of one another would be fine, with a proper straw roof, so the rain couldn't get in. And Oinky maintained that the best thing would be to use longer branches and twigs of appropriate lengths to build the house, with a roof of moss and large leaves. Piggy wrinkled his snout and scratched between his ears, saying that Hoggy and Oinky had no idea what to do for the best. Their planned house construction could lead to a catastrophe. It wouldn't be long before they'd be left high and dry, with no house and no home. You always know best, don't you, Piggy? Said Hoggy. Yes, you always make us out to be a bit thick, continued Oinky. Not surprising, since you are thick, remarked Piggy, turning on his heel and trotting away. Hoggy raked some large piles of straw together and pressed them into square blocks, which he bound together with string. They looked rather like massive Christmas presents with decorative rosettes tied on the ends of the string. Then he piled the bales of straw on top of one another into four walls, leaving two holes as windows and another as a door. And for the roof, he bound large bundles of straw together, angling them against one another so that no rain could come into the house.